This is a really good book. So with that said, flip this open. Chess 5334, Problems, Games, and Combinations. Introduction by Bruce Pandolfini. Author Laszlo Polgar. Publisher Test Press. Copyright 1994. An earlier version of the book was published in Germany under the title Polgar Chess, Training in 5,333 plus 1 Positions. Alright, ready? Thanks, I'll need it. Or yeah, I'm sorry, that's not good luck, that's have fun. I'll still need all the luck I can take. I do have a bookmark in this book, so this isn't a completely blind run. I have several times attempted to finish this book, and I think this time, with the timer there, I can at least have some motivation to say, you know what, I'm actually going to try to finish it this time. For realsies. Do I have a bookmark that's not torn? I suppose this will have to... No, this isn't very good. I don't know what to do. I need a bookmark. Could use this pamphlet? Yeah, this will work. Cool. It's a paper pamphlet telling you to recycle. I can't tell if it was made with recycled paper, but it really doesn't look like it. Anyway, here we go. Here we go. I have to turn on global hotkeys. Wait, was X my global hotkey button? Let's find out. X, here we go. No. Alright. What were my hotkeys? Toggle global hotkeys is... Oh, that was the select button, wasn't it? Yeah, button 6. Alright. So splits, save layout. Put the focus back on this window. Back here. Turn them on and go. There are more than 5,000 problems in this book. Most of them can be solved within a few minutes. There are few books containing chess problems, games, and endgames which are not only easy to solve, but elegant and instructive as well. And there are even fewer that offer a sufficient number for regular and intensive training over a relatively long period. With this book, I would like to provide some help for those who are learning the game alone, and for parents and for coaches too. A word of guidance before we start. First, learn the names and the colors of the squares on the chessboard. Never move the pieces while solving a problem. Solving the problems in this book may result in a considerable improvement in your tactics, logic, concentration, and imagination, and will also be a source of motivation. Nothing is as encouraging as success and achievement. You can use your new knowledge in playing with partners and in tournaments too. Studying the miniature games, maximum of 25 moves, will help you to avoid errors in game opening, and it will improve your arsenal for attacking the king. Children are more interested in short games, and they can concentrate on them better than long ones. The two miniature games, maximum number of pieces 7, are not difficult, but they are enjoyable, and make it possible to proceed to more challenging chess problems. They may also inspire you to study the literature dealing with problems, or even to create your own chess problems. This book draws on my private collection of 5,000 chess books and my archives of periodicals going back 150 years. I have also used the experience gained in the training of my three daughters, Olympic gold medalists, Oscar award winners, holders of several Guinness records, champions of the world, for many years first and second in the world ranking. And during my 15-year activity as a chess tutor in extracurricular classes at various schools. In addition to studying the book, beginners who may wish to become tournament chess players should play every day, even against a chess computer if they do not have a regular partner. I guess this was pre-internet, or pre the internet becoming a really big thing. So, at that time, I could understand why he's recommending playing against a computer. But I would think that these days you probably want to play against a human player. And the repeated problems in this book will repay repeated solving and study. The book aims to strengthen the positive skills and discipline needed for competition in chess and any other field, but above all, it aims to give pleasure. Apart from the foreword that I'm currently reading, and the chapter Key to Symbols, the following 1,000 pages are written in international chess terms, and thus the book can be read in any country by those who wish to improve their knowledge. The chapters containing problems and combinations might be useful for setting up problem-solving contests. The problems figuring in this collection, The problems figuring in this collection cover the history of chess literature from 1140 to the present. There are problems by Grandmaster Paul Benko, the international grandmaster, created especially for this collection, and there are 125 combinations from the tournament games of the Polgar sisters. This book is primarily intended for beginners and amateurs from the basic level to the master candidate 2200 ELO, and can be enjoyed by players of all ages. I wish to thank Koenemann Verlag for making it possible to publish a chess book of so wide a scope, Coulter Trade for editing the manuscript, my daughters for their help in professional matters, and my wife for her help with technical problems. Budapest, 1994, Laszlo Polgár. Introduction by Bruce Pandolfini. Chess, as this Laszlo Polgár volume is titled, is perhaps the most comprehensive book conceived on the art of checkmate. It contains some 5,334 examples, primarily dealing with mate, mating attacks, or forced endgame wins. Mr. Polgár, the father and personal chess trainer of the renowned Polgár Sisters of Hungary, has provided over 1,100 pages of brilliantly organized didactic and practical paradigms to equip the reader with the weapons needed to play power chess. Here constructed is the path followed by Zuza, Sofia, and Judith Polgár in their meteoric climb to the top of the chess pantheon. It is said that each sister worked through and played out similar groups of their father's carefully chosen and arranged examples, until vital patterns and schemes became second nature, very like the way music students master finger exercises. The format is beautifully logical, as with all grand strategies. There are sections of related problems, 6 large diagrams per page. Examples in next section are subdivided further based on which player, white or black, moves first. The text is minimal, but the presentation is clear enough for even beginning students. Anyway, it's well known that the best chess instruction is largely visual. Of the initial 4,462 problems here, 306 are mate in one move, 3,411 are mates in two move, The attacker plays, the defender responds, and the attacker checkmates on the second move. And 743 are mates in three moves. Some of these mates have been composed for instructional purposes, but others have been taken from real chess games. Each of these sections is large enough to constitute a book in itself, and the chapter on mates in two alone could enrich several years of study. Following the mating problems is a phenomenal section with 600 miniature games, examples 4,463 to 5,062. All the moves of every game given in figurine algebraic notation for easy use, showing the symbol, not using the letters, so that people in any language can be able to read it. Each game begins with the opening moves, guiding the reader to a pivotal moment. A diagram prompts the reader to find the next move, suggested by the subsection in which the game appears. For instance, if the game is in the F3 section, the winning move must be made to the square F3 if it is black's move, or F6 if it is white's move. What better clue could be given than an indication of the destination square? Next is a chapter of basic endgame positions, puzzles 5063 to 5206. Each of just a few pieces and mainly concluded by promoting a pawn into a queen. Important patterns, because many games reduce to a situation where the extra queen assists checkmate. From this Olympian preparation, the book moves into its final chapter, examples 5207 to 5333, consisting of short tactical games played by the Polgar sisters themselves. These contests all illustrate incisive attacks and winning stratagems used by Zusa, Zofia, and Judith in their confrontations with masters and world-class players throughout their tournament and match careers. The solutions and pertinent factual information, place, date, and name of opponent, are found in the concluding segment containing all the answers for the book's 5,334 examples. The very last diagram, by the way, is a bonus problem created by the middle sister, Sofia Polgar, the placement of the pieces, tracing an outline of a rook. This tome ends with a short biographical sketch of the author and a helpful bibliography of sources of the problems not personally developed by Laszlo Polgar. If you are new to the game, you can begin at page 1 and proceed step by step. Chess conveniently provides a pithy introduction to the moves and rules, for some reason omitted from most tactical books. Even experienced players might prefer reviewing this introduction before tackling the actual problems. Another approach, just as viable, is to focus on particular sections or themes for special study, since each grouping, though part of a logical whole, is also a self-contained unit. You might decide not to work directly from the book, but to set up problems on a chessboard. If so, first try to solve them without moving the pieces. This develops analytic vision and improves overall ability. Whether your level of skill or level of interest, you will find that Laszlo Polgar's chess offers an abundance of instruction and pleasure and provides a superb foundation for any chess library. Hey, welcome. Yeah, good sunny day. All right, key to symbols. All right, shows you these are the chess pieces. These are what white pieces and black pieces look like. These are pawns, rooks, knights, bishops, queens, and kings. This is the starting position. Square A1 is always a black square. Black is always in the top of the diagram. White is always at the bottom. The letters, there's one per file, which are the vertical rows of squares. And numbers are indicated in the horizontal rows of squares. indicating each rank, and each square can be denoted by a letter and a number. And the move number plus the symbol of the piece, or if the piece is a pawn, there's no symbol, plus the square the piece travels to, indicates the move. So, knight moving to c3 is indicated as nc3. Alright, a position with only kings is indicated as a draw. And also the equal sign is the annotation for a draw. Plus minus is the annotation for white is winning. Minus plus is the annotation for black is winning. And the octothorp, hashtag, if you will, or pound sign, is the checkmate symbol. So those are the symbols. The king, and it shows you how the king moves. The king may move one square in any direction, as long as no piece is blocking its path. The king can capture in any direction. The king may not move onto a square occupied by a friendly piece, or where it is checked by an enemy piece, checked meaning the king would be attacked on that square, or adjacent to the enemy king. The queen moves vertically, horizontally, or diagonally any number of squares so long as there is no blocking piece. However, it cannot move as a knight. The queen can move on top of a opposing piece to capture it. The rook moves any number of squares horizontally or vertically as long as no piece is blocking its path. It may elect to capture an opposing pawn or piece on a square. There's the castling move, where the king moves two squares and the rook moves to the square through which the king passed. You cannot castle if the king is in check, if there's any peace between the king and the rook, if the king will be in check after castling, or if the square that the king passes through is under attack, or if the king or rook have previously moved. The knight moves in an L shape, two vertically and one horizontally, or two horizontally and one vertically. It may jump over pieces, but may not occupy squares already occupied by friendly pieces. The bishop moves diagonally any number of squares, so long as no piece is blocking its path. It captures similarly to other pieces. The pawn moves one square forward. On its first move, it may move two squares forward. It may capture a piece by moving diagonally. The pawn may not move backwards, it can only move forward. And this often leads to a characteristic called pawn chains, or various other pawn structures where one pawn stands in front of another and neither one can move. If a pawn moves forward two squares, an opposing pawn can capture it on the square through which it moved, but only on the next turn. Really confusing rule. And if the pawn reaches the top rank or bottom rank on the chessboard, it must be exchanged for a friendly piece, being a rook, queen, knight, or bishop. If you have your original queen, you can still promote to another queen. A king is in check. If an opposing piece attacks it, king can never be captured. King must get out of check, either by moving the king, capturing the piece that's giving the check, or interposing a friendly piece to block the check. If the king cannot escape from check, position is checkmate. If the king cannot move and is not in checkmate, and the player whose turn it is cannot move any other piece, the game ends in a draw by stalemate. This is actually a feature of Western chess that's not shared by, say, Shangi or Shogi. If I remember correctly, in those variations, stalemate is a win. But in Western chess, stalemate is a draw. And they show some examples. So that said, that's our introduction, key to symbols and forward.
There'll be considerably less reading
for the rest of this, or at least reading aloud. So here we go. Mating one, number one. All right, queen g7 mate. Mating one, number two, queen h7, queen g7, rook h3, rook h8, rook g1, rook h1, rook h1, rook g1, bishop a6, rook d8, bishop takes h7, queen f7, queen h5, rook e8, queen takes h7, rook d8, knight g6, pawn takes g8 equals knight, f8 equals queen. This one's tricky. I think I see it. Just want to be sure. D takes e8 equals knight. Is that mate? Yes, D takes e8 equals knight. Bishop a6. Queen c6. Knight d7. Knight f5, queen h7, knight e6, knight f7, bishop f7 double check, h7, turn page turn, there we go, queen g7, d7, queen b7, rook c7, rook h7, rook h6, queen d7, knight g7, queen c7, rook g8, rook h7, knight d6, rook e5, f3 is mate. Okay, queen d6. F4, queen e5, f8 queen. Queen g6. 50's tricky. It looks tricky. Oh, I see it. Queen b7. Queen g2. Knight of six. Oh gosh, three pawns that could promote. Wow. Is it what I think it is? G8 knight. Queen h7. D7, b7. Queen e4. Queen g8. Queen e5. Queen g6, knight c7, knight b6, knight c6, b7, knight b6, knight c7, rook h2, king f7, okay, that is me, rook f5, bishop f3, knight e5, bishop d4, rook b7, rook h7, rook g8, rook e6, wow, I see several checks. Where's the mate? Rook e7's the mate. Rook d6. Bishop f1. Bishop f5. Bishop f1. Bishop d8. Bishop e8. Rook a8, rather. Queen h6. Queen f5. Queen f7. Queen e6. Rook b8. Rook a8. Queen f3, Is this also queen f3? Yes. Queen e8. Queen e8. Queen e5. Queen g5. Yeah, that is mate, right? Queen f1. Queen b1. Queen h1. Queen e2. Queen e2. Queen f3. Wait, what? Oh, queen c8. Queen d5. Queen d6. Is that right? That's unusual. Queen f1. Queen h6. Queen f1. Queen d4. Queen h8. Queen h8. Queen h8. Queen ec4. Queen f3. Queen d8. Queen e4. Queen d1. Bishop f8. Queen e5. Bishop d4, queen e6, queen e6, queen e5, queen g4, queen g4, queen e5, queen e7, queen f8, that one's tricky, where is it? Queen e6, no, queen ae6. Queen AE8, Queen HE5, Rook A7, Bishop E5, Bishop F6, Bishop D4, Knight F7, Knight D6, Queen E7, Rook A8, Rook H7, Rook A3, Rook H3, Rook A3, Rook A6, Queen B6, Queen A6, I meant to say Queen B3, Queen A3, I know what I mean. Let's see. Hello. Oh, yeah, you already said hi. You probably left by now. This one's queen b3, right? We're on 147. No, we're on 145. My button must have failed a couple times. Queen b3. Queen b3. Queen b3. Queen e5. Queen a8, queen a8, queen d6, queen g7, queen b3, queen b3 still works. Alright, 157. Things are starting to get real. There's a lot more pieces on this board now. It's still mate in one, though. I mean, how hard could it be? Queen a4. Bishop a4, queen g8, rook g8, knight a6 doesn't work here. My first guess, though, does, right? Yeah, knight d7, queen b7. Okay, it's a double take on this h6 mate. Queen e6, queen e6, bishop a5, e7, rook g6, knight f6 double check. Oh, that is a discovered checkmate. Wow. Bishop d4. EF7 double check. F7 discovered mate. Queen G6 checkmate. Knight F6 smothered mate. Knight F7 smothered mate. Queen E8 mate. Bishop A6. Knight E7 double check and mate. Queen H8. Knight B6. Queen H7, Knight D6, Rook E8, Bishop G7, Rook G2 works, nice. Queen D5, Queen G6, Queen H7, Bishop E5. Knight d6, rook h8, knight g6, queen g6, knight g7, queen g7, bishop g5, knight d5, knight g6, bishop d5, knight f6, knight e7, knight d6, Knight d6, queen f5, rook d8, bishop f6, knight to h6, bishop b5, queen h7, knight h6, bishop f6, rook g1, rook e8, rook e8, rook h1, bishop c5, Bishop d6, double check. Bishop a7. Oh, I do have all these squares covered. Rook h4. D8 rook. D8 knight. Gf. 7. Hey, welcome. Yeah, now I am solving the Polgar book. It's a fun little exercise. Queen g7. Rook c7. Queen e3. Really? King b1. Queen d6. King d6. Rook h8, f7, rook g7, rook d7, knight a7, queen takes rook mate, queen f7, rook g4, G7, knight h6, bishop d6, pawn takes rook, c3, rook a5, c4, F6, Knight B5, let's see. Yeah, unfortunately I cannot share the book. The book is under copyright, so all I can do is share the timer, which shows the position that I'm on, rather the puzzle number. So if you have the book or have a legal means of obtaining it, feel free to play along at home. I do strongly recommend the book. It's a very good book for all the reasons mentioned in the foreword that I read aloud earlier. I might come back and read it again at some point. Yeah, but sadly, I can't share the positions themselves. Rook g6. E7, Rook A7, Rook E7, Bishop H5, Knight D5, A3, Knight F5, Knight F7, Queen C6, C5, Knight D7, these are all mate and one puzzles, and most of them are really easy. Occasionally I might get stumped though. Yeah. Well, you don't see me playing video games, do you? Not often. Even that's a gray area, but this is very clearly black and white copyrighted. I'm not doing anything to enhance the work in presenting it in its original form. So, seems pretty black and white that I can't share the book itself. GH7. Queen B8. All right, what do we got? Oh yeah, no, I can review the book. I just can't show the actual book. Unless I'm doing something to add to the work. And me reciting the solutions as I discover them isn't really adding to the work. No, a review would be not if I'm doing this live stream thing, but if I had some kind of formal review process and I'm publishing something that's well considered. And that adds to the work. I'm just solving it live. It's not adding. It's an interesting point, but I'm pretty sure that I can't. Even if I could, sharing the book would only convince people in my audience to spew out the solutions. And where's the fun in that? Now, if people can obtain the book legally and play along, that's fully permissible. People want to just hang out, we can do that too. I don't have any problem with that. Queen g8. D8 rook. Bishop c7. Bishop f7. Now, if this were Lee chess puzzles, that'd be something different, but Lee chess don't hold a candle to this book. This book's awesome. Knight b4. Bishop f7, knight fe7. Also, I just think this is a fun experiment. At some point, this will slow down and we'll have more time to chat. But now I'm just burning through the first chapter. Ed6, c6 surprisingly works. That's a black queen on d5. That makes this a bit more challenging. Oh, is that a. Wow. gf5 discovered mate. I'm sorry, fg5. Queen g7. Oh, we're talking about the Polgar book, the one in the screenshot in the corner. That's the one I'm solving. I've had it on the shelf forever. Never got around to solving it completely, so hopefully with the timer this time I'll actually get through it and be done with it. It's a good book. Bishop b8. Knight f6, c5, g5, c6. Rook d8. Queen b4. Oh, knight g5 doesn't work here, but rook h5 does. Bishop h3. Is this simple? Knight f5, yeah. C7. Rook h8. That's funny. Yeah, with this administration, journalism is going to be important. That's why I keep telling Nightbot to keep putting that link out there. Knight f7. Queen h1. e8 knight. Wait, that's... Oh yeah, that is pinned. Knight g6. Queen f8. F8 knight. Bishop g7. Queen a7. Rook h8. G5. Knight e6. Rook a5. Bishop d8, rook c6, bishop c4, pawn takes knight, queen f7, bishop h6, knight c7, queen c6, f7. Where's this one? This is mate in one? Oh yeah, knight c5. That's really unusual. Castle's mate. King b5 is not mate. I split early. Oops. we'll find it. It's not king b5 though. Oh wait, no, it must be king b5. This must be a publication error because there's no other mate. Like, I considered every other move in the position that has any potential to checkmate. That bishop should be on g1, not on f1. Wait, no, no, I'm sorry. No, it's pawn takes b6, en passant, checkmate. And the way I know that that's the answer... well, shoot, no, I split early. There we go. Yeah, en passant, checkmate. And we know that it must be en passant checkmate because black's only legal previous move could have been pawn b7 to b5. Whew. Okay, that's mate in one, guys. Alright. Oh. Alright, cool. Let's see. You think I should do this under, like, Twitch creative reading? Oh, that's cool. Yeah. So, yeah, that's... I mean, like I said, I'm not reading the contents of the book. I'm pretty sure it's under copyright. But we can all hang out as I solve it. Got through chapter one, mate in one. Took... I mean, the timer says 4012. Alright, mate in two. Here we go. King c3. King c4. That's unusual. Where's the mate? Oh, queen b1. Queen h2. Queen f5. Um, 2. This is starting to get more difficult, guys. Oh, knight h5. Got a bishop and knight versus a king that has a pawn. There's some way that white can... I'm thinking he can lose a tempo, but it's not so clear. Seriously, how does white lose a tempo? He can't move the knight. Can he? There's no way. Oh, I'm sorry, you just invert the move order. Knight f7. Queen h3. Oh yeah, totally. Once I beat this, Stockfish is going down. Doesn't even have a chance to draw. It's just gonna get wrecked. That's what this is all about. No. Bishop b3, mate and 2. Queen a2. Wait, what? I mean, the only move must be queen d3, but where's the solution? Yeah, queen d3 mates either way. Some of these puzzles, you make a move and your opponent has multiple options and you have a different solution for each option. Bishop g4. Oh, I've seen something very much like this before. We've got a pinned rook. I'm going to see something like it again soon, I'm sure. Wait, okay, a queen e1. Black has two moves. Both of them get mated. So yeah, we are tied up on 320, so that's cool. I haven't dropped an input in a while. How do I mate in 2 here? Knight e5. Tricky stuff. Wait, is this as easy as it looks? King c3. King f2. These are starting to get complicated. Wait, does that mate? Can I play knight d5, threatening to bring my queen in? If I do so, black can move either king a6 or king a5. King a5 is not legal. It's got two moves, both of them fall to queen b6. So yeah, knight d5 mates. Knight e6. Now I'm reading the Polgar book and solving it, and I should be consulting the solutions, except I'm certain that I'm right, so that's a way to save time. Just solve them. Have no doubt that you're correct. Because you can see all of your opponent's legal moves, and so you see that there's a checkmate at the end of each one of them. Yeah, knight g6, queen f2, was expecting something more idiomatic here. Alright, what do we got here? Emailed the Polgar Foundation asking permission to present the booklet. I mean, you're welcome to do that, I guess. I'm not sharing the book. I'm sharing my discovery of the solutions, which have nothing to do with the contents of what I'm reading. They are my own creative work, so I can share that. I'm not sharing the book. But, oh, I'm sorry, you're asking, can I share the book? But I'd have to set that up. But, I mean, given the history of some of the actors in that situation, I'm not optimistic. But you know, maybe we'll return to this some months later and have the book available for all that. That could be fun. We probably have better luck finding a different puzzle set that was suited for this kind of format. But yeah, who knows? They might say yes. They probably won't. And they probably won't in a timely manner. But it could be fun if they did. Also, even if they say yes, political situation being what it may be, they might not have the rights to say that for much longer, so that would be unfortunate, and that has nothing to do with anything I'm doing, but that'd be sad. So where's the mate? Where is it? I want to keep this pawn pinned to the king. And yeah, if you have the book, feel free to play along at home. You could even erase this and make this a Speedrun Live category at some point. That'd be fantastic. It's probably too much for most people. It's a bad sign that I'm getting tripped up on 327, though, when there's so many more problems to go. Like, if I move my king, that makes it too easy for black to escape. If I move my queen too far away, the black king can run. If I move my rook, I mean, I was looking at rook g3, but I don't see what to do after king f4. It can't be rook g3. Can't. Rook h4 looks wrong, because black's moves are f2 or king d3. Neither of which white has a mate. It's got to be a queen move. Huh. Hey, the only reason for the streaming requirement is for proof calling purposes. I don't think anybody's going to proof call this. Oops. My book closed. Plus the answer key's in the back, for gosh sake. So, not that I'm using the answer key, but, I mean, even if people were streaming it, that wouldn't prove anything. So, really, having the book on stream has no impact on this whatsoever. This is just for fun and for learning. And just as something that I can do to keep us entertained. Note, I did put up the TV, and people are still complaining. It's unfortunate. okay, but yeah, if I do king e5, he does king d3 and gets away. If I do rook h4, he does f2 and gets away. If I do queen e5, I mean, there's just too many squares he can run to. If I do queen c2, king f4, then what? I don't have any mate to follow that. So I keep going back to rook g3, but it doesn't work. Rook f3 gives away too much material. I mean, if you buy the book, you can follow along at home. If you have the book, you can follow along at home. If you otherwise somehow legally obtain the book, you could do that too. Yeah, I'm currently on the chapter Mate in Two. I'm looking at a position that has five pieces. No, these are. I think these are. Well, until the last few hundred or so, these are all checkmate puzzles. The last few hundred have to do with draws in endgames and wins in endgames, and just finding the best move. But first 4,000 some of these are all checkmate puzzles of really high caliber. Oh wait, okay, so I've been discarding queen g2 on account of being afraid of losing my queen. But that pawn cannot take my queen. So, I think it is going once and twice. Yeah, queen g2 mates in two. Nice. That was tough. Rook a2. Where's the mate here? Queen f7, knight e6, rook e7. Well, that's a funny puzzle. Where is it? Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Like, I can't take that because, oh, bishop f8. I saw that and rejected it, and now I see it again and it works. So, yeah, of course. Knight f7. Queen g6. Oh, it does not mate, does it? Oh, that's unfortunate. Gotta go back one. Knight e6. Rook g1. Queen c3. Knight h4. That's an unusual position. So, like, all the obvious moves leave black a single way to escape, and if I cover that escape path, then it's stalemate. That's pretty unusual. So unusual something is called for here. Can't. Well, no, maybe. If I do nothing, it's stalemate. Where's the mate? Why is this one so tricky? Why is this so tricky? There's only five pieces on this board, and all of, well, there's the black king and four white pieces. One of them is a pawn that can't move anywhere. One of them is a king, which, if moved, does nothing to lift the stalemate idea. Wait, it's not stalemate, though, because the king can take the pawn. Still, there's no way. I mean, the king needs to remain where it is. Otherwise, there's no mate threat. So easy. So easy. Supposed to be the easy part. Why is this book so difficult? Have I committed some grave mistake? Yeah, it's just a mate in two. I mean, how hard could that be? Okay, suppose I move the knight. Suppose I set up what I think it wants me to set up, but that doesn't work, does it? No, of course not. My knight can't cover the square adjacent to it. It could be a knight move, but the other knight moves seem pretty crazy. Like, if I move it backwards, okay, what, black has one legal move there. Oh, wait, no, because that's not mate. It's a single square off. It really doesn't look like a knight move, though. Also, there will be a video on demand, so people could play along afterward if they obtain the book somehow. they could make sense of my whimsical comments. But, jeez. Wait. No, I rejected that, like, how long ago was that? 5 minutes ago I rejected it. But that's the solution. Oh my goodness. That's so dumb. Queen e6, king d8, knight c6, checkmate. Okay. There's a pawn in that position, and it does nothing but mislead you. It's great. We're gonna make chess great again. Okay. Got it. So, hopefully,
I can knight d4, can get through the rest of these without that many issues. Queen h7. Oh, wait, really? No, that's too good to be true. If the run takes less than 16 hours, which it might not. Okay, whatever. Come on, where is it? Where's the mate? Plus, you were hearing my solutions. You'd be cheating. Not that that matters. So it's got to be a queen move or a knight move. It really, really doesn't look like a knight move. A knight move does not work, so it's got to be a queen move. But what? How could this possibly be mate in two? Oh, now I feel dumb. Knight f5. Okay. Found it. Wait, is that so? Rook f6. See everything but the key variation, which is great. Yeah, I'm not surprised. Most of these are pretty simple. I've actually seen some of these before, so in a sense I'm cheating, but what can I do at this point? Other than just give up and not do this. Where's the fun in that? We're gonna finish this book and say we did it, and we'll be done. So. Oh, wow. There's a puzzle where the first move is not check. I mean, that's kind of typical of a lot of puzzles in this book. But, wait, that doesn't work though. It's so close, but it doesn't quite fit the bill. Six pieces, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's a 7-piece position. Does that work? Can I move my rook? Is that why the pawn's there? But why that rook move? Why does it matter which rook move I make? Oh, because I need to cover that square, right? Right, there's two squares uncovered that point. If I do that, that still doesn't cover the mate square. Could I sack the rook? No, that sack doesn't work. Okay. Oh. Really, it's a retreating move. It's always a retreating move. Except when it's an advancing move. So yeah, knight a5. There we go. You got it. Wasn't that hard. This one looks extremely easy. Yeah, rook a1. That balances out with the last one. Not really, but... why can't I do d4? Why isn't d4 the answer? It really feels like the answer. Search your feelings, you know it to be true. Oh, now how cool would it be if I could set the king up on d4 and my queen had somewhere to go where it covered all the dark squares? That's not doable, though. But after d4, king e4, then queen e6, king d4. So... after queen d8, just because it's a move to the edge of the board, black plays king e6 and gets away, so that doesn't work. Huh. Could it be knight c4 or knight g4? If knight c4... I mean, knight g4, he just king d5, and he's out. He's not out. Knight c4, likewise, king d5 just runs into e4 mate. Yeah, knight g4 seems to do it. I don't see any tricks. Yeah, knight g4. This one's gotta be Zugzwang, right? I keep waiting for the Zugzwang problem. Which is ironic in itself. Just keep waiting to get blasted by some absolutely insanely ridiculous Zugzwang. And so far, these problems haven't been stupidly difficult like that. But you know there's going to be one, and it's going to strike when you're least suspecting it. And it's going to make the puzzle, like, impossible and a half. So... where is it? We got a knight and a queen versus a king and two pawns. We've got a king and a knight and a queen versus a king and two pawns. It's gotta be there somewhere. This book hasn't lied to me yet. Well, except for the one publication error. That error aside, the book hasn't lied to me. Where is it? I don't want to skip any of these either. I mean, what's the point if you're going to skip some of them? Unless you're going to skip to the good part. The whole book's the good part. Yay. So... Wait, really? Okay, I didn't think that possible, but, you know, Queen E3. Mates either way. Okay, now why is there not a Zugzwan here? I say there's not because my king can't go anywhere preserving the Zugzwan. I can't move my knight. Queen G3. So many of these are instructive because the direct attack does work. You just have to find the correct way to approach. And it's not always trivial. Yeah, Queen F3. That one's pretty simple or straightforward compared to other ones. Okay, Queen F5. Like, there aren't very many trick problems. At least not in this part. I think a later section consists of tricky, or compositions, rather, which are just brutal. Absolutely brutal. And fun. But mostly brutal. So... I mean, what the heck can White do here? Okay, if he doesn't move... If he moves the bishop, there's still the stalemate, unless he does bishop f4, which doesn't help. This is gonna have to be something other than the bishop move. Let's see. Yeah, it's fantastic. These far exceed the quality of most computer-generated puzzles. This even preceded most of the internet. And I'm sure that it preceded its publication date in some sort of form. Yeah. Yeah, so far, out of 350 of these, there's only been one publication error. And it's pretty clear that... No, sorry, that wasn't a publication error. That was set up correctly. The move was en passant, mate in one. I've misspoken on multiple occasions. Yeah, out of the first 350, all of them are valid. Now, as for whether he did it all by himself, I don't know. Maybe he had the time to do that, but I'd be surprised if he didn't have an assistant, but I don't know. But yeah, this predates the internet. So this, he said this is taken from 5,000 books as well as from numerous tournament games and various other sources. So, I mean, either he's quite the enthusiast or this is a very collaborative work that he's still brilliantly bringing it together. Somebody has to check these. Wait, is this... This is what I think it is. So I can get my controller ready here. Yeah, Queen C2. Mates either way. Really tricky stuff, but the knight protects squares except in the line where it's taken. Okay. Next one.
This looks familiar. This looks very familiar, because I struggled so badly with it last time I read this book. But, yeah, I think I see the solution this time. Which is encouraging, and saying something about my ability to learn a thing or two. So, three candidate moves there for the opponent. It seems at least two of them have him escaping, though, so maybe I didn't remember this. Wait. Does knight g4 work? Knight g4, if king f5, queen f6, if king d5, bishop f7 is... maybe? Looks like mate. Not entirely sure. That's a really weird pattern. Yeah, knight g4. Wait, this is a really obvious mate in two. Queen b3. Bishop c5. Queen g4. Right, what do we got? All of them? Well, we'll see. I reserve the right to abort this if I get stuck. Or for any other reason. But yeah, we're gonna see how far I can get. Is this bishop e2? No, it's not. Is this bishop d1? Bishop d1, knight e2, queen f2. It's not mate. I need the bishop to cover f3. And d1's the only square, but if knight e2, what do I do? Cry. Crying sounds like a good option there. Your guess is that all of them probably take around 15 hours to solve. Okay. Well, in that case, we might not be concluding the book today. Yeah. My other thought with this would be just leave the timer running and just see how long it takes me. Not just today, but over a series of days to complete this, but, yeah. 15 probably doesn't sound inaccurate. If I could just get through, like, all the mate and two puzzles, that'd be an achievement in itself. Unfortunately, I didn't manage to find time over the winter break to do this. So, we're doing it now. we're trying. Bing, bing, bing. Sounds a little like a pinball machine. Can I do bishop e5 here?
Bishop e5, king d2. Does the king get away after bishop f4? Yes. The king does get away. Can I do bishop e1? King d4. Ah, I got nothing. Just need a move that moves none of the pieces. So black has to move, and I just mate in one pretty trivially. But I don't have such a move. So I have to find a different mate in two. Queen f6. King d3. Wait, is bishop f5 mate? No. Is bishop e2? No. Queen d4 is not. Wow. I'm sure you guys are just going to tell me this one's really easy, because it's just a mate in two. Stockfish would be like, what are you even thinking about? This is so obviously mate in two. So I can't sack the queen. That'd be fun, but it doesn't work. Okay, my queen covers e4 and d3. Could I do queen c2, maybe? Or b1. Is there even a difference between c2 and b1? And from c2, I can go to e2 next. Queen c2, there's no king move. So the knight moves somewhere. If the knight goes to e2, well, either way, I still need to cover the f4 square. No, if it goes to d3 or e2, that both seems to impede my access to f4. How about h7, queen h7? There's still no king move, right? I think it's queen h7. It's still problematic because I can't cover the e4 square and check diagonally. Meaning my next check would have to be on e4 or on the e-file, and that's not going to work for all possible defenses. I keep going back to queen c2, but there's no way. I mean, against moves other than knight d3 and knight e2, it works great, but against those two, I don't see a solution. Well, I better call work and tell them. No, just kidding. Yeah, this might not have been the most well-considered idea, though I was enamored with the idea of doing this. And such a thing could be fun, but this is proving much too challenging. How about this? If I get stuck for a half hour on any given puzzle, that's where I'm calling it. And the goal is to see how many I can get through until that happens. That shouldn't happen. And that's not to say that that's the only way I could quit. But it would sure make a good excuse. If Curry can get to master in a year,
Surely I can solve this book in a day. That's like the most illogical argument ever. I can't. Wait, I haven't considered Queen E5. I should consider it. Queen E5, King ED3 is the only move. Similarly, Queen C5. Oh, Queen C5 is an interesting variation. King E4, Queen D4, mate. Queen C5. Let's see, what else could he do? Could do King D3. Is Bishop F5 mate there? So, have I exhausted all the legal moves? Yeah, Queen C5 followed by either Queen D4 or Bishop F5 does mate. Damn, mate in two puzzles. Multiple solutions. I mean, they're realistic. It's good to be aware of them, but how often are you going to use them in your games? Yeah, I'm sure some of these are harder to solve than others. I'm really looking forward to the F3, G3, H3 puzzles, which I haven't seen in many years. And I've only seen a handful of them, and they were quite fun. Just reading through some of them as just preparing for a chess tournament. So what do I do? Wait. I'm still looking for a zugzwang problem, and there just aren't any. Oh. Yeah, Queen F4. Yeah, Lee Chess has tons of zugzwang problems, which makes them easy to find because you know the key move is a zugzwang move. You know what to look for. Rook H8. Why is there. How do I lose a tempo here? Where is my tempo losing move? It's not there. This is not a zugzwang problem. I could put that pawn anywhere else on the board and I have really easy mate in one. But because it's there, I have to find something else. It's a beautiful puzzle. There's a queen, and there's three pawns, two white, one black. And the goal, obviously, is mate in two. But the means to get there is very much not obvious. Seriously, where is it? I can't let the king run. But, I mean, my other moves don't make any sense either. Oh, I see. Queen F3 pawn moves, then Queen F7 mate. I've seen this one before. It's a silly under-promotion puzzle, if I remember right. I don't. Why would I? I mean, it's a really easy win, but where's the mate in two? Where's the flashy move? That might actually be necessary in some situations, but not this one. Where is it? Oh goodness, is this really a Zugzwang? After everything I said about suspecting, this one might actually be a Zugzwang. No. Rook b5 knight e7. Just dashes to pieces all my hopes and dreams of a Zugzwang. Oh my goodness, I'm being stupid. Yeah, I look for all the under-promotions and zigzag moves and everything other than the most obvious candidate move here, b8 queen. Super obvious move if you're not trying to do something tricky. But if you are, it's pretty hard to find. Bishop d6. Queen d5. Really, is this it? I mean, that looks like it. Knight e4, king d3, knight f4, mate. These simple direct mates are awesome. Queen d5. G5. Okay, now this one. Number 365. All your pieces are, like, right in each other's way. So mating in two is just, oh, Rook H to G3. Simple. Your pieces have to walk around each other to get there. But it's doable. Oh. Yeah, now this looks straightforward. Okay, king d5. Black has two candidate moves, and both of them get mated by different ways. I know, king d5, king g5, queen h6. King d5, d6, queen g4? That's not mate. As I suspected. So I found the candidate move. I mean, it's gotta be, or the key move must be king d5. But if d6, yeah, then bishop e4 is not mate. Still, it's gotta be king d5, right? You have to keep hold of the e5 square. It'd be crazy if it were something else. Okay, maybe king e7, though, protects the rook. Protecting f6, that's pretty key square, too. What's the threat? Is there a threat? I don't see a threat there. Can I do bishop e6 or something? Bishop e6, if king g5, queen h6 mate. Bishop e6, if king e4. I mean, white's totally winning this, but where's the mate? I don't see it. This is why I was saying king d5 initially. It's because after king g5, then queen h6 pretty obviously mates, but after d6, I don't see anything obvious. I mean, you could continue the pattern and just move king d4 and then queen e3 is the threat, but that takes three moves, not two. It's a marvel I got as far as I did in this book. I don't remember it being this hard. What about the silly move, bishop g4? Discover check. King e4, do I have anything? I do not. Not even close. Bishop d3. King g5, rook g6 is not mate. Oh, how about bishop h7? Check. King g5 is forced. Rook f5, check. Can the king go anywhere? F file's covered, h file's covered. That is the most unusual checkmate I've seen in a long time. Bishop h7, there's only one move for black, and then rook f5 is checkmate. Right? Am I right? Am I right? I am correct. Wow, okay. That was worth looking at. That's something, I mean, it's not going to occur in my game, but it'd be awesome if it did. People be like, yeah! He studied the Polgar book. Puzzle number 366. It's right there. And then they'd walk away in shame. But for a brief moment, it would be awesome. So if knight c6, king b7, rook b8, is everything covered? It sure looks like it. Once, yeah, no, that's gotta be it. This one really looks like rook e8 and queen d8, but isn't. Or rook c6, king d7, queen d8 doesn't work. It hangs all the pieces. Rook c6, king d7, queen d5 is mate. I see a nice mate that doesn't work. If you ignore the stalemate rule, just black passes. That's not what these puzzles are about.
Oh, wait, really? Knight c8, king e8, bishop b7, checkmate. Yep. Queen f3, king h4, queen g3, mate. Oh, I remember this 371. I'm gonna be seeing it in my sleep. It's brutal. The sight of this particular problem makes me want to quit the challenge right now. Because I remember I struggled with this one. It was horrible. So we struggle once more. Wait, if king e5, king e2, queen d1 is not checkmate. So moving my king gives up the e3 square, which seems like a big no-no, unless I can find some way for that to work in my favor. But no, I can't cover e3, f3, and f4. Well, no, my king and e5 would cover f4, though. But I can't cover e3, f3, and d2. With just my queen. Because some of those are light squares, some of those are dark squares, and I can't put my queen on a square that attacks them all. So, it's going to be a queen move, or a knight move, because I can't give up e3. Knight d1 comes to mind. Knight g4 comes to mind because it looks ridiculous and is, if, well, no, king f4 is illegal. Yeah, knight g4, if pawn takes queen f1 mate, is not mate. Never mind. Queen f2 is mate. Knight g4, so pawn takes queen f2 is mate. Pawn f4, then what? Oh, knight e5 mates? No. How does f4 play into my hands? How can I make pawn f4 into something positive for me? That's another reason to look for a queen move. Wait, queen g6. King e2 is the only move. Because, I mean, f4, queen g4 mates, and one. But king e2 might suffice. Unless I have a different key move. Like, if I play queen g5 first, there's no reason to put it on g6. That doesn't work. How about queen h1? H1, the king's got a lot of... Well, it looks like he's got a lot of escape squares, but he doesn't really. But those escape squares seem to be enough to get the king out. Arr! So, yeah, if we look at this rate, 370 puzzles in about 2 hours. So we say 400 puzzles in 2 hours. And that's mostly the easy puzzles. Yeah, this is going to take upwards of 20 hours. I don't have time for that, unfortunately. I might play through just the white to move mate in two puzzles and then call it there, if not earlier. 371.
here. Okay. Just taking a moment to relax. Okay, let's take a look back at this puzzle. How many more are we going to move? Oh, that's a lot. Yeah, maybe we pause after 400 then. Yeah, that's a ton of puzzles. Can we get to number 400, I wonder? Or am I going to quit before then? I mean, the last chapters might include a lot of easy puzzles too. So this might not be completely, totally brutal. But, yeah, it's not looking like this is feasible. Which is okay, because there were some different games I wanted to play. Anyhow, I had that arranged in the case where this didn't quite work out. So, 371 is amazingly challenging. I mean, how do you cover F3 and E2 without upsetting the current state of affairs there? There's so many squares to cover and so few pieces that white can move. If he moves either of the knights, the other one's hanging unless defended by a king or a queen. So moving either knight looks dubious at best. Yet if a knight doesn't move, it's going to be still a challenging puzzle. Like, if I could pick my opponent's move, that would make this so much simpler. But I cannot. I have to play the hand I've been dealt. So king e5, king e2, queen d1 is mate. No, it's not, because of king e3. Because I moved my king. So queen c1, king g2. There's nothing there. Queen h1, king e2, queen d1 mates. Queen h1, king g3. Okay, after king g3, queen h3 mates. Queen h1, king f4 is illegal. King g4 is illegal. So I thought black had a lot more options than he actually had. Somehow I just didn't see my knights are covering so many squares. Seeing the retreating move, which seems to allow your opponent to go either direction, is a little tricky. But yeah, queen h1's the answer. Next puzzle. Do I underpromote? Do I finally get to underpromote here? Probably not. That'd be too nice. I do if I don't underpromote? Wait, do I take a rook promotion, maybe, to avoid protecting my knight? D8 rook, king takes c7. Does not cover the b6 square. And furthermore, there's no way to be able to cover that. Okay, what about knight d5? Knight d5, king e6. Promote to a piece that checks him somehow. No, it doesn't work. But what's the point of the pawn in this problem? Maybe the point is to get rid of some potential duplicate solutions. So yeah, knight d5, king a6, bishop b7, mates. That's the only line. I just don't understand why the pawn's there. But okay. Cool, we got it. Is 400 even put... 400 isn't even on a page boundary. I need to have food. If I don't have food, it's not gonna go positively. So to ensure a positive experience, we need to prepare some food. Let me briefly mute my mic as I use the restroom as well. Muted. Thank you. Sorry about that. I'm just having a little bit of lunch here. I'm actually solving the book chess by Laszlo Polgár. There's a little bit of intentional ambiguity in that title. Because that helps people get interested in what in the world this is. Back to number 373. That's good food. Oh. See, having food makes some of these puzzles easier than not having food. You can't focus when you're hungry. Yeah, this is pretty simple, straightforward. You play Queen H2. I need to focus my timer application. Play Queen H2, and then if King F3, Queen G2 mate, and if King to the first rank, Rook G1 mate, Knight C3, no silly knight mates here. Oh, simple. Rook takes B7. Well, I'm surprised in the power of having food. Food havingness is a good thing. Some of these puzzles are still quite difficult, though. Wait, is this simple Queen D3? King runs away, Queen E3 mate. Sure looks that way. Yep, that's it. Keep looking for every way to hang a piece in the most ridiculous manner. But no, these are actually good training. Yes, this is a, I would consider it an essential puzzle book to any serious chess player. Serious is a pretty strong word. We know lost the Polgar and what he did. Yeah, I don't know if he authored this book to what extent. I mean, he does give credit to people who assisted him, but I don't know if other those people had assistance or what, because this seems like it's over 1,000 pages. You'd have to be completely obsessed to come up with these amazingly fantastic problems. There's a normal person working a normal job would not have the time or the effort or the skill to put forward such a fantastic set of problems. In my opinion, it just doesn't seem doable. But somehow, this book exists. It's excellent. And any seriously competitive player should solve this book at some point or another. That said, not everybody has to be a serious competitive chess player, but yeah, I would consider this pretty important. Perhaps you know more than I. Oh, is this simple? Wait, no, there's the sack there, but the sack. Oh, yeah, the sack still. Black still loses to the same mate. Knight to f3. Unlike Lee chess puzzles, these are actually encouraging good habits. Now, solving them all at once is probably not a good habit, but you're not encouraged to find the most ridiculous move in the position every time. Often, you're supposed to find just the most reasonable move that happens to be very strong. So, it's not a zugzwang problem because this book has very few of those, apparently. Like, every time I keep looking for a zugzwang, it's just not there. Seems every time white moves with purpose. Not with the purpose of just waiting for the opponent to move. I think I see it. Does black only have one move? That's also kind of unusual for these, but yeah. Knight g4, e3, queen e5. Yep, that's mate. 379. That looks like a straightforward mate in 2 until you realize which way the pawns are going. Oh. But because the pawns are going that way, yeah, rook a1 instead of rook takes pawn. 380.
E5, King H4, there's no mate. Queen E3, King H4, again, no mate. Queen E7, King H2, Queen H4. Okay, Queen E7, King F4. Seems like a lost cause. Knight H3 fails. Knight E2. Oh, that might be it. Knight E2. Yeah, if King F3, Queen F4, if King H, Queen H. 5. Yeah. King A, 381. This looks straightforward once you've seen something like it. Wait, but that's deceiving. This is not as straightforward as it appears. Like, I'd like to play knight f8, king e8, b8 equals queen, but there's a tactical issue with that. But yeah, if white doesn't move the knight with check, then what's the point of moving the knight? Okay, what about queen b5? King e8. No, it's not legal. Oh, wow. That's hope chess. Yeah, queen b5, and then you promote to a queen with mate. 382. Okay. Let's see. We got some comments here. How we get here? My custom stuffing is too cool. This is chess. Would you rather see the... Yeah. Well, unfortunately, Llama Lord, the book is copyrighted. So... I can't share it with people who don't already have it. But if people have it, they can play along at home. I'm currently on number 382. You know, it'd be awesome if one day this book were not under copyright. If this were put into the public domain, and then we could speedrun this on SRL. Although, once you solve the book once, you would think that the next time around it'd be a lot easier. But you never know. Yeah, 5,334 problems, combinations, and games. I haven't even gotten to the later chapters in my earlier attempts at this book. And I figure, you know what? Curry Howard says that in 420 days he's going to become a master. Well, we're going to see how quickly we could solve this book. Only because I've had the book forever. And solving the book in under 420 hours would be quite the achievement. It's the book Chess. It's the one in the corner. Come on, all chess players who have potential have autism of some sort. Not really. I'm just kidding. But no, it takes a special kind of dedication to the game to get anywhere with it. Alright, what do we got here? Stop spamming caps, but what was this? Ah.
Besides, I don't think you're a psychologist. What do you know? Or rather, I should say, how do you know that? What makes you think that that's the case? Let's try to be less skeptical this year. I'll try to be more open-minded. How about that for a New Year's resolution? Yeah, Bishop F3. Next one. This really looks like C5. It's very difficult to imagine that C5 is not the move here. Yeah, it's definitely C5. 384. Well. The damn bishop. Damn that bishop. Ruining all my fun. Oh, except for the one little fun that remains. Queen H1. Next page. So everybody's gotten a different opinion on life. Right. 385. How is this not Bishop C5? How is this not? No, it is. There we go. 386. Can my king, can my knight not check that king? It definitely looks like my knight can check. Yep, knight b5. 387. Knight g4 seems to. Yeah. I mean, black can't move, so he's got to move the pawn. Alright. It's knight g4, 388. Queen a3, 389. Why can't there be some silly zugzwang? I'm not entertained. This is intended to be instructive, though, rather than entertaining. So I don't get any of the cool zugzwang tricks. Yeah, again, just plugging the whole journalism thing, because that's important this year. And the next 3 years. And potentially four more after that, and who knows how many after that. I have a different game I want to stream at some point. It's probably going to come later today. So, Queen E2. Queen E2. Black has two king moves, or two legal moves, King C1 and King C3, that both fail to Queen C2 mate. So, Queen E2 is the key. Okay, how is this not pawn takes pawn check? This really looks like pawn takes pawn check. But that doesn't work. How about queen e3? Queen e3, king f5, queen e4. Is there anything else? No, queen e3 is the key move. 391. Man, taking that break so improved my productivity. I actually don't know much advice. Have I considered breaking copyright laws? I mean, you're gonna need to provide more context. If you're talking about this, I'm not going to publish the book because I respect the author and I respect the copyright. It's not that I'm afraid of the law, it's that I respect it. I think that better things will come if somebody comes up with a collection of puzzles that aren't under this sort of copyright, or if this gets released into the public domain. It's not out of fear. It's that I'm doing what I think is right. I know that kind of sucks, but breaking that kind of copyright isn't something I'm intending to do. Yeah, look for Laszlo Polgár. See my final split there, 5-3-3-4 chess, that lists the author name. Also, the icon in the upper right corner shows the icon of the book that you're looking for. What's the link about? What's the link about? Oh, I have a minute to chat here. I'll have a minute to have some food. What's this? Well, okay. Yeah, I'll allow it. And if it's something awful, I'll just ban you. I'm kidding, but whoops. Permit wiki to post the link. Fine, whatever. Yep. Yeah. That's nice. Very funny. I think you missed the part where I said I respect the author and I respect the copyright. That's okay. I mean, there's really not much I could do to stop that anyhow. But I'll do what I can. Because I do respect the author, and I do respect the copyright. And it's because of that that usually I can't have nice things here. People ask me why I have these policies and rules on my channel, and I don't know. It's because information does spread quickly on the internet. I mean, it's psychologist Laszlo Polgár. I encourage people to learn more about him. He put together this excellent collection. I'm sure he worked for many years to put this together. Ori paid people a considerable amount to work with him, and now people are freely distributing the book. It's because of things like this that puzzles on most chess sites are shit. It's because of this that there isn't much in the way of good paid quality content online. It's because of this that even where there are, when there is good content, the user interface isn't necessarily the best. I honestly don't know what he did in terms of his professional work, but it's clear that this book took a considerable amount of effort to put together. And if he did rehash someone's work, that'd be kind of ironic that somebody shared his book here, but yeah. I don't know how somebody makes a living in psychology anyhow, but if he managed to offer some service to his institution and to humanity, if he in some way contributed to the community, I don't know. Even if he did plagiarize or something like that, I think that's still helping his local community, if nothing else. It might not be the noblest thing, but clearly he must have been good at what he did. I've heard of Jung. Yeah. I can't say that I minored in psychology. At least truthfully, I cannot say that. Certainly the name Jung is quite famous. Chess is hard. Chess is very difficult. Thankfully, today all I'm trying to do is solve the book. The one that's indicated in the corner of my stream here. Now, which one of them was the crazy one? You know, what actually would have been the proper response to him sharing that link? The proper response would have been to just immediately terminate this exercise and say we're done. Just to prove a point that he's not doing us a service. Yeah. He's understandably popular. I wonder what drove him to think that. I mean, you can't just come up with a theory like that for no reason. There must have been some reason he came up with that theory. I know, as much as I'm saying that, like, a resolution could be to keep a more open mind, it seems I'm being quite controversial here. Oh, this is a mate in two. This is really easy. Knight f6. If king h8, queen takes rook. If king h6, bishop c1. Not obvious. It's like something Stockfish would find. 392. What a silly puzzle. Yeah. But, like, what... How is it that people subscribe to his theory? Or that he wasn't just, like, a total recluse from society for having such a theory? I mean, people to some extent must have accepted what he was saying, so he must have had some reason he said what he did, even if he didn't believe it. Even though maybe he did. We don't know. Yeah, no, I'm just saying, like, during his time, if you judge him in the context of his time, he must have said something that somebody thought was reasonable. Even if today what he said sounds completely insane. I mean, people used to believe that using leeches on people to help them stop bleeding was a good thing. Or to bleed them, rather. People used to believe all sorts of things about blood. And today we have science. Oh, I missed the obvious solution here. Queen takes f4. Next one... So this one, he is actually threatening to check me if I don't do something smart. Queen g8, next one. Okay, what are we saying? Yeah, at least physics has a scientific method. And increasingly, I suppose, other... disciplines do. You know, a while ago the psychologists Myers and Briggs came up with the Myers-Briggs type indicator. The notion was that you're supposed to be balanced. Even though nobody's completely balanced, but that, just have a well-rounded personality type, and today people are happy about being some type or a different type, at least if I understand correctly. I could be completely off base. So is this not Queen C1? Queen c1 threatens queen d1 and queen f1, but does not guard the e3 square if I go to either of those. So there's got to be something else, like knight c4. Yeah, knight c4 guards the second rank square. Oh, I remember this one. Ish. Not really. Yeah, rook h2. Okay, this one. Okay, what have I missed? Yeah, no. That said, there is a website out there that judges your chess personality. And, I don't know, I've become a more well-rounded player over time. I'm not a psychologist. So, yeah, I'm not sure what to tell you. Oh, my Moses. Oh, is this something I get to set up? Yeah, that looks awesome here. Oh, but knight f3, intending castle mate, fails. Ah, wait. Can I move my rook anywhere on the b-file? And then, no, I can't. So yeah, if it were black's move, black plays king d3 and I castle checkmate. But it's white's move. So I have to find something else. Something less elegant. This one's tricky. I keep wanting to try to get the castle checkmate thing to work, but for that to happen, my rook has to stay on the fourth rank so the other rook can mate. But if I'm moving on the fourth rank, then that frees the king to go to the b-file, and it doesn't work. So, where else? And the two squares I wanted. Yeah. What a mess. Wait. Okay. No, rook a2, king d3, rook d4. Rook a2, king c1, knight e2. Ah, llama. Ah, llama's got the book. Or he knows the position. It's probably a famous position. I'm not sure whether to troll you or not. So I'll do the chess. So, yeah, I might do another 23 problems just to end it on a nice round number. 23, 24, I don't know. Well, looks like my apartment has a bug visiting. Fantastic. Let me clean this up a little bit. Get the food out of here so this bug goes away. It seems to come out whenever there's food. Oh, got a link. What was this? Ah, right. Chesspersonality.com. Thank you. back to the chess. Back to the solving the Polgar book. Beginner tutorials. I guess Chess Network. Check out leechess.org/video also. They have a section especially for beginners. I haven't looked at it, but I trust that's good. But yeah, other people feel free to suggest things. You could always check out the Llama Lord's speedrun of Lee Chess Basics. Under the Learn menu in the upper left corner, there is a section called Chess Basics that helps you get acquainted with the rules. Where's the mate? Where's the mate? Was it queen f6? Why only that move? Why not queen g7, queen h8? We have queen f6, queen a1. That's ugly. Queen b3, queen takes rook. Now, if queen b4, that doesn't work. Can't I just ask my partner for another queen? It's the best way to learn chess. It's the speedrun way. Wait, is this simply king d3? And then, if, regardless what black plays, white mates. King d3. King d1. Damn it. It does not work. King e1, though. Forces black to commit to something, but then he could play queen takes rook. Very tricky. What about king takes pawn? King takes pawn, king d1. It seems too obvious. Yeah, no, it's king takes pawn. That's the answer. Next one. Yeah, congrats, man. You're already the champ. What further life aspirations could you ever have? Puzzles are tricky. wonder how the Polgar sisters would have done if they had been subjected not to this training regimen, but to Lee chess puzzles. They would probably have a much different perspective on how the game works. And just a deep, deep skepticism about any position. That could... I mean, somebody inevitably is going to produce such an experiment, and it's going to be sad. Knight b7? Doesn't look like it. No. That lifts the threat. Is this knight f2? Nope, definitely not knight f2. Well, no. Could be, not on account of king d4. Knight f2, king d4, queen a7, mate. It's not mate. It's got d5. But queen c4 is mate. And it sets up something kind of symmetric. And if the king goes to e3... And then there's no mate there, though. Hey, Cormac. We've almost solved 400 puzzles. And, not only that, we have read the introduction, which did take some time to read. So. Queen f1, king d5, queen c4 is not mate. Knight e3 just fails miserably. Knight h6 doesn't serve any useful purpose. Knight h2 does not help. Knight h6 does cover f5, but it's just not good enough. Yeah, no, I'm solving a book in front of me that I'm not allowed to put on stream. Not only not allowed, I just... the author put many years of work into producing the book, and it's not mine to give away. I should be more precise in my speaking. So if queen f6, am I threatening anything? Yeah, but... Well, actually, that is a zugzwang, right? Yeah. Guys, like the one position where I've been figuring there's not a zugzwang is the one where it happens. But I think I see the correct answer. Yeah. Well, that was a mess and a half. But yeah, queen f6. It's 399. The point. Why do I feel like it's rook c1?
Probably because I've probably seen this puzzle before. Rook c1, king d4. Shoot. Rook c4? Is that mate? It is. If he goes the other way, we've got queen c2 mate. Alright, 400. Queen e2. If king f5. Well, okay, if king d5, queen e6 mate. King f5, queen e5 mate. 401. Queen e4. That seems too easy. Okay. Queen e4 it is. It's a good centralizing move. And mates, regardless of which way black goes. 402. You can't let black check, but you have to lift the stalemate. Oh, it's simply queen h2. The only move that where black has only one legal reply. Two legal replies. Yeah, doesn't seem right. What else could it be? Queen h2 looks either like I've seen it before or it just feels right. Because it's a check. And, okay, you have king e6, queen d6 mate. If rook f4... I thought that queen f4 is mate, but it's not. But is there something else? Perhaps not. Oh, queen h5 instead. Queen h5 for the rook blocks, queen takes rook's mate. If the king goes up, queen d5 is mate. That's 402. 403. I think I could get through these. I think I can get through a few more. And then after these, I'll move on and play some more interactive stream-friendly game. Alright, what do we got here? Yeah, unfortunately, I can't... I mean, the book isn't mine to publish. And... no chess site has any problem set nearly as good as this. Not even Chess Tempo. Chess Tempo is good, but it's not as good as this. And this is something I want to do. And the only way I'm going to manage to get through it is if I stream it. But I'm here to chat, converse, and kibitz and stuff. And for those of you who actually have the book, feel free to follow along. Maybe even race me. Although I've got a 402 puzzle head start on you, so that might not be a fair race. But yeah, I'm thinking I might do another 18 of these. So if rook c3, bishop's pins, the only move's king b4. Queen d4 is not mate on account of bishop c4. Knight c6 not mate because bishop takes knight. Eric, what a mess. Rook a4 on move 1's no good. Stalemate. Oh, rook b3. Why rook b3? Why not rook somewhere else on the rank? How's this better? Oh, sorry, rook b3 stalemate.
be 7. Oh. Yeah, this author really loves to use the knights. You can create some fantastically interesting positions where a knight ends up moving or not moving. The ones where the knights move are really tricky to follow. It gives me an idea for a special kind of puzzle trainer where many of the moves, but not all of them, but many of them end up being knight moves. Just to train you on finding some really obscure, well, not even obscure, but just challenging to find for human knight move tactics. Yeah, it's the chess 5-4 problems book. Missed the boat. Yeah, no, we're getting there. Oh, I'm sorry, you're saying 1-4. No, it's 5-4. See my last split down there? We are currently on the mate into section of this. Right now I'm 2 hours into mate in two puzzles. Which means the previous section took us 40 minutes. For introduction and mate in one. I should actually combine that together. Although breaking it out's not a problem. It's interesting that queen d4 doesn't work here. Oh, rook d8. Mates either way. Nice. Yeah, rook d8 mates. 405. Oh, why can't I get to the g2 square? Oh, I can. I just have to check to get there. Queen takes pawn check. 406. No, the a3 pawn's not defended. There's so few pieces on this board. You'd think there would be an obvious solution. There is not. Yeah. You're right, although I don't have enough space to enlarge the image without reducing the clock size, so I'm kind of stuck there. Unfortunately, the book has a vertical layout, otherwise I'd probably put it where the graph normally goes, below the splits. But, yeah, I think as long as it's known that this is the chess book, and as long as we know that the author is Laszlo Polgár, it's pretty easy to find the book. But yeah, if one of you wants to write a book, 1,307 really awesome chess positions, by all means, have fun. could be a fun thing. Could be the meme book that has all of Zug's tragic, I don't know, experiences. Oh, wait, this is simple. Knight b3, king a4, queen c4, mate. Only move. 407. This really looks like queen f7. Like, this is mate in two if I play queen f7. Pretty obviously so. Black doesn't have any alternative moves, so yeah, there it is, queen f7. 408. Oh, I've seen this one before. This is a hilarious bishop puzzle. If I remember right, it's bishop a6. If the bishop goes off the diagonal, it's a pretty simple mate. And if the bishop stays on the diagonal, white doesn't. The g pawn has to move. I'm thinking of a different position then.
Oh, queen g4. Hanging the queen. If bishop b7, there's no mate. Queen g2. a5, then what? Still no mate. Queen g6. Threatening back rank as well as mate on the diagonal. Black can move bishop to h1. Can't cover. Yeah, wait, no. Queen g6, bishop b7. Doesn't cut it. I keep thinking I'm seeing the answer, and it's not so simple. Like, why is this one so tricky? What are we looking at here? Oh, poor Zog. He searches for such fantastic things in chess. It's amazing what he finds. I don't know how he finds it. This is queen e3. Queen e3 is pretty boring, but no, there's bishop b7. How do I address all the ideas here? It seems like no matter what I try, Black's got some way out of it. And unfortunately, this is the mate in 2 section, not the mate in 3 section. Queen f2, bishop b7, queen e3, bishop b7, queen anywhere, bishop b7, other than queen b6, but queen b6 makes no sense. Bishop g2, bishop takes, no, doesn't work, but a5 works. I really want my queen where the bishop stands. What a mess. Oh, yeah, I've seen this before. But what does that do about bishop b7? I could have sworn that it's queen g6 here. But then if bishop b7, there's no check. You can't checkmate without a check. Queen takes pawn. Bishop b7's no good. Curious, is this 408 solvable? If 408's not solvable, then the run is completed. No, this book hasn't let me down yet. Says white to play and win. Yeah, this one looks tricky. The material balance is white has a king, queen, and bishop. Black has a king, bishop, and 2 pawns. And it really looks like Black is able to move one of those pawns and get out of any kind of mating threat that could happen. So, well, I see mates in 3. I'm not seeing a mate in 2. So if it's not bishop a6, what could it possibly be? How could white attack the b7 square without moving his pieces? Seems like black has bishop b7 as a reply to everything unless white plays a piece onto the diagonal. Or unless white plays bishop a6. But in either event, oh, I miscalculated. It's one bishop g2. The only move that retains control of the a7 square. That's tricky. 409. What just wants to zugzwang black, but there's no zugzwang square. So white needs to directly mate with rook c7 and queen takes knight. And it's that simple. 410. Oh, good gravy. All the pieces are on the edges of the board. It's a beautiful position, but what do you do? How in the world do you react to a position where all your pieces are badly placed? I want to centralize them all, but there's not enough tempo, not enough tempi to do that. So... what squares are covered? Everything other than e6 and e4 is covered. Is there any piece that could cover e6, e4, and all the flight squares that are reached for e6 and e4 without giving up a whole bunch of flight squares? I don't think so. It's like if I do rook a4, king e6, I don't know. Right. We're making progress, guys. Rook f1, king e6, queen g4, it's not mate. Surprising. It is, never mind. But if rook f1, king e4, is queen g6 mate? So that's a really nice dual theme. Yeah, it is. So rook f1 check. Centralizes the rook, and allows you to centralize the queen, and... brilliant. 411. Oh, if only it were black's move. That'd be so simple. Things are never simple. How does white approach black? How does white approach black? How's this bishop g3? This really looks like that. Yeah, I mean, black doesn't have any other advancing or retreating moves, so bishop g3 and queen d6 mate. Regardless of what black plays. Four 12. I've got a king, two knights, and a pawn versus a king and two pawns. Knights are tricky. This book teaches you to better appreciate how they work. But here, I need to land a knight on f7 after h6, so I need to play knight e5 to send that to knight f7. And black doesn't... Oh, after knight e5, black could play king f6. Never mind, false alarm. I was going to say this is really simple, but it's not. Oh. It's a nice two knights, mate. Knight e6 check, king h5, knight f6, mate. Entirely linear. Alright. There we go. We split successfully. 4-13. My kingdom for giving my opponent a tempo. But I'm pretty sure this is queen g6. Black plays anything, queen g1 mate. 4-14. Pretty sure it's rook f8 and then bishop g8. Oh no, bishop f5. Because the only other checks in the position are rook d7 and e6. Those are actually kind of reasonable too. I'm curious. Which of these is the best? Rook d7 seems to give black too many escape squares. E6, king takes. Does seem enticing. How does it fail? Oh, because f6 is loose. Okay, so yeah, my initial reaction, rook f8, and then bishop f5 is correct. At 4:15. Whoops. No page turn there. We just moved the bookmark over. Alright. Well, this seems like an echo of something we saw 200 problems ago. So, what do we got? Got plenty of nothing. Wait. Is this one a king move? How often does a king move that's not check constitute the biggest threat in the position? No, that can't be. That's unreal. There's too many flight squares. What about rook g4? King f5, then king e7, mate? Is that mate? That looks like mate. You know, after hundreds of these, you start to question which ones are actually checkmate and which ones aren't. But yeah. Rook g4, if king h5, then rook h8. Rook g4 of king f5, king e7, mate. 4:16. It'd be nice to transfer the tempo to the opponent. Really seems like the only idea is a7. But that doesn't seem to mate. Oh, this is funny. King d8, smothered mate next turn. Next puzzle. B7, king takes pawn, B8, queen mate. Yes. Next puzzle. that looks funny. Oh, knight C8, king A8, pawn takes B7, mate. 419. 4-19. Oh, knight c6 and queen a5. And then the puzzle we've all been waiting for, 4-20. Alright. This is actually not the easiest puzzle ever. So I'm appreciative that I'm not just flipping through this. Oh, no, I got it. It's rook a1, king b3, knight d4 mate. So we got that. It's good progress. Got through the best of the puzzles.
Just kidding.
But yeah, it seems like progressing further. Not. I guess I could scroll up a bit and we could take a look at the earlier splits. There's a lot of subsplits here that are all part of the mate and two category. So you took 40 minutes for mate and, well, for everything preceding the mate and one, plus the mate and one. Introduction took 17 minutes. I'm going to estimate 2 minutes of this time spent was for a break. And so yeah, we got through 420 chess puzzles. There's a lot more to go. But it seems like people are tiring of this. They keep asking for the same thing, which is that I publish the book, and I'm not going to do that. But it was a good exercise. 420 out of 5334 is less than 10%. So probably estimate, this completing this could take at least 30 hours of really diligent study. Now, I mean, late in the book there are endgame puzzles, there are puzzles where they tell you the destination square. They're all thematic. But between where I'm at and there's also some compositions, which are super intense. Just saying. So I'm actually impressed. Let's see. Currently on page 126. My old bookmark in this book, by the way, is at page 358. Meaning I've probably spent 12 hours on this book at one point, just trying to get through it. Today we spent 3. Some of that was a little distracted, but this is all good progress. I didn't think the book was going to be this difficult. I knew it was super challenging, but I just apparently can't count to 5,334. So, that all said, I'm going to pause the timer there at 3:19. We'll save what we got so far. You know, I'm going to actually save this. And we'll save this as a personal best. Run terminated. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm going to pick this up anytime soon, because this is an enormous amount of work. You should have seen the amount of time it took me just to put these splits together. You can see it's got like all the sections here. Forward, introduction, key to symbols, mate in 1, 2, 2, etc.
compositions and the final puzzle in the book. We'll maybe never see that puzzle. Who knows? I don't think having the positions on a screen would help make it any easier to solve, though. I actually prefer the book format, although it doesn't do any favors for you over there. So, hope you enjoyed. Let's take a minute and commentate on this game. This is a really high-level game that's going on here. Between Luca and Luca 1950 and Apelsins. Alright, just moving this over so it doesn't occlude my board. Wait, develops all his pieces. I assume White's gonna play like F. Well, okay, H4. This actually raises an interesting point that one of the developers and I were discussing the other day about how do you identify which positions are similar to other positions. And I suggested that pawn structure is quite important. And when we were trying to figure out, well, what does that exactly mean? Ding, 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 ding. Okay. But yeah, one thing we found is that in Sokolov's book about pawn structures and middle games, he does mention, well, at least the positions he exhibits show pawns on e5 or on d5, rarely on f5, or on h5, and never on g5, as far as I could see. So there's a very strong bias toward white advancing pawns in the center, and not a strong bias apparently against the g-pawn. So we saw in this game white pushed the h-pawn. It just reminds me of the Sokolov book, where there really weren't too many positions where the g-pawn would advance, but the h-pawn would. Even more frequently than the e-pawn, or the f-pawn. So it'd be like e, most common, h, second most common, f, third most common, and g-pawn to g5, fourth most common, that's to say, least common. So white's exchanging down for some reason. F5 is loose. Black sees that and doesn't want to be stuck playing bishop g6. So he defends f5 right away. White loses the b-pawn, which was lost. Well, also black's defending against knight takes a6. Tricks. So yeah, white's going to have to try to salvage this endgame. Meanwhile, black just safely advances. I mean, yes, there's tactical tricks, but what? Black's pretty safe here. Wait, what's with that? Yeah, I didn't like king g7 at all. There's no need and no reason to retreat like that. Oh, black has to take this, doesn't he? Oh, can you take that? I missed that. Whoa. Whoa. This is not going to work for white. There's no way that this works in any sense other than white might win on time, which would be a shame. Knight c3, a4 is coming. Oh, there goes the bishop. a2. You need to get your knight to b3. That's not toward b3, that's away from b3. Oh, well, that's a clever try, but ignores the b3 square. King takes pawn. Yes, king e5, king g4, h3, king g3, h2. No, knight d3. Yes, knight f2 next. And you've got it. Well played. That's how you win. That's how you do your end games. Anyhow, I hope this has been fun. Thanks for watching, and we'll be playing a more casual game next time. Take care.